carrying a leather purse in a paper bag, wearing jeans and a shawl, which she didn't take off, though it was more than 90 degrees out when the rain had no air conditioning. He was driving an old Dodge Charger with a bad exhaust system, one long crack in the route behind which he pulled over her.
She got right in.
Put the leather purse in the seat between them, and settled herself with a paper bag in her lap between her hands. He just crossed into Texas from Oklahoma.
Where are you headed?
Nevada.
Nevada, maybe?
180.
And that fast he was answering her questions.
Just got out of the Air Force.
This wasn't exactly true. You see, the Air Force had given him a dishonorable discharge after 4 years at Lebanon for assaulting a staff sergeant. He was a bad character.
He had a bad temper that got him into a load of trouble. He just wanted to head out west, after wide open spaces. Just to see it, really.
He had a feeling that people didn't really require as much from the personality as that. He didn't have any family now. He had $5,000 from his father's insurance policy. He was going to make that money last about.
Sort of undecided about a lot of things.
Not me.
Figured out where you're going?
You could say that.
Where might that be?
She made a face and then extended her thumb and turned it over.
Under. Down.
Excuse me?
Does the radio work?
It's on the blink.
She turned the knob
anyway.
Then she sat back and folded her arms over the paper bag. She was skinny and long, and her hair was the color of water in a metal pail.
She looked just old enough for high school. What's in the bag?
Nothing. Another blouse.
Are you going to Nevada?
Why not?
All right.
And for some reason, he offered her his hand.
She looked at it
and smiled at him, and then put his hand back on the wheel. It got a little awkward almost right away. Finally, she fell asleep. And for a while, he could look at her without worrying about anything, but staying on the road.
He decided she was kind of good looking around the eyes and mouth. She slept very quietly.
You ought to be out.
You hungry?
No.
What's your name? I never got your name.
Belle Starr.
Belle Starr.
Come on, any Oakley, Wild Bill Hickok.
Oh, okay.
That's me. Belle Starr.
That's not
good. So I'm gonna go by these days.
They rode in silence for a time.
What's your name?
He told her.
Irish.
I hadn't really thought about it.
Where have you been?
Prison.
He hadn't known he would say it. And now that he had, he kept his eye on it.
What about you?
Well, what about me?
Where are you from?
I don't want to bore you with all the practice.
I don't mind, I have nothing else to do.
Maine. Land of moose and lobster.
Maine. Well, now.
See? Lobsters are things that don't change.
Unless you change them. Go to sleep?
Just relax.
But a moment later, when he asked her if she wanted to stop and eat,
she didn't answer.
He looked over and saw that she was sound asleep. He drove until dusk, stopped only for gas. And the girl slept right through. Just past the line into New Mexico, he pulled off the interstate.
Where are we?
New Mexico. I'm looking for a place to eat.
I'm not hungry.
You might be able to go all day without eating, but I got a 3-meal-a-day habit to support. You got food in there?
Yeah.
Listen, you're kind of pretty when you sleep. Childlike, sort of. You're quiet as a mouse.
And you think I'm pretty?
I guess you know a thing like that. I hope it doesn't offend you.
I don't like dirty remarks. But I can tell you didn't mean it to be dirty.
Dirty?
Sometimes people can say a thing like that and mean it very dirty. But I can tell you didn't.
Well?
I don't think I'll go in with you.
You can get a cold drink. Come on.
You go in. I'll stay here.
Come on, I'll buy you dinner. I'll buy you a cold drink and dinner.
I don't.
He he got out and started for the entrance. And before he reached it, he heard a door open and close and turned to watch it come toward him. The diner was empty.
Everything seemed in order, but no one was around.
I guess we're supposed to see it ourselves.
This is weird. Hello? Anybody here?
Yeah.
You open?
I guess maybe I am.
You got a menu?
Truth is, I'm selling this place. I don't have menus anymore. I make hamburgers and breakfast stuff, some french fries and cold drinks, a hot dog maybe. I'm not keeping track.
Let's go somewhere else.
Sit down and I'll make you a hamburger. On the house.
I don't like hamburgers.
You want a hot dog? I got a hot dog for you. Guaranteed to please.
I'll have french fries.
You're the second customer I've had all week, bub.
Guess that cash register's empty then. Huh?
It ain't full, honey. On the house.
And the girl brought a gun out from under her shawl.
A pistol that looked like a toy.
Suppose you open up that register! Mr. Poormouth.
The man looked at her.
This thing's loaded. And I'll use it.
McRae started to get off the stool.
Hold on a minute.
His words got by the mouth full of food, and then everything started happening at once.
The girl and the pistol.
There was a clapping sound. A single small
clap. Not much louder than the sound of a cat, man.
The man took a step back and introduced his fan.
He stared at her wide-eyed.
It would seem like a long time.
And then he went down.
This is a tremendous shattering.
Jesus Christ.
And went around and opened the cash register.
Damn.
Jesus Christ!
And now she looked at him.
What are you sitting there with your hands up like that for?
Oh God.
Stop it. We put our hands down. The cash register's empty.
She gazed over at the body. Oh, where did it fall in?
Damn.
He couldn't talk.
Focus, clearly,
poor thing. He began to cry.
Will you stop it? Jam the pistol on his forehead.
Oh, Jesus, good Jesus!
I think you better get out of here. What do you think?
Take the car.
Interstate went on into the dark, beyond a glow of headlights. We lost track of the mile, road signs, other traffic, time. All the while, the girl sat watching, her hand somewhere under the shawl. For a long time, heard the only sound of the rushing night air at the windows.
What were you a present for, anyway?
You could have been able to answer.
Come on, I'm getting bored with all this quiet. What were you in prison for?
I beat up a guy.
That's all?
Yes, that's all.
Look, I didn't shoot the guy for money, you know? I shot him because he made a nasty remark to me about the hot tub.
Did you hear a nasty remark?
At the end of that, he used to be alive.
The grain held tight to the steering wheel.
You know, I'm not really from Maine. I'm from Florida.
Florida.
I don't run after money. That's not what I'm after.
No.
What I'm after is adventure.
Right.
Fast living,
right.
A good time.
Good.
And I'm going to live a ton before I die.
A ton, yes.
What about you?
Yes, me too.
Want to join up with me?
Join up, right.
Good.
kind of feeling as though he might start throwing up when he had up the hamburger.
His stomach was cramping and he was dizzy. He might even be having a heart attack.
Your eyes are as big as saucers. You know how old I've been, Frank? I'm 19. How old are you?
23.
Do you think people go to heaven when they die?
Oh, God.
Belle, Starr.
Amazing.
Look, we're going to run out of gas here pretty soon.
Great if I knew what might happen with the gas right now. You knew it as if she spelled it all out for me. You can't try for the cunning you would need.
Hey, Belle. Why don't we lay low in Albuquerque for a few days?
Is that a scene gesture?
No. It's outlaw talk. It's prison talk.
Well, I've never been in prison.
That's all I meant.
You want to hide up?
Yeah.
You and me?
You asked me to join up with
you. Did I?
Yeah, you don't remember?
Yes, I do.
You did. Belle started a gang.
She did?
Yeah. I could be the first member of the gang.
I like that idea. Belle Star and her gang.
Anyway.
Right.
Yeah?
Can you pull over?
Why don't we let it run out of gas first? She was
silent.
We'll be that much further down the road.
I know. Pull over anywhere. Take this exit.
Hold on to a ramp. Headed toward a glow that burns on the horizon.
My mother's men friends used to do whatever they wanted to me. But not all the time. All sorts of them seem going on.
Sorry that happened to you, Belle.
For a moment, he was surprised by the sincerity of his feeling.
As if he couldn't feel sorry enough. Yet
it was genuine. It had to do with his own unhappy story.
I'm really very sorry.
Pull over now.
Pull the car over and slow your stop.
Let's get out. Now.
The whole thing was slipping away from him.
Come on. Real slow.
Jesus. You're not gonna do this, are you? I thought we were friends.
Just get out. Like I said.
Hey, don't shoot.
He opened his door.
All his talk had come to nothing.
All the questions she'd asked him, and everything he told her.
It was all completely useless.
This would happen to him. It wouldn't mean anything. It would just be what happened.
Real slow. Like I said.
Why are you doing this? You have to tell me that at least.
Will you please just get out of the car now? All right. Shoot where he said.
Okay, don't shoot.
He's backing himself out, keeping his eyes on the little barrel of the gun. And he can hear something coming. He seemed to hear it the same instant she said,
Wait.
A truck came over the hill ahead of him. A tractor train. A white light and roaring.
Stay still.
The truck came faster. It was only 50 yards away. Without having to decide about it, without even knowing that he could do it,
the train bolted into the road.
Prison. The whole country wandering and the strength's money in his pocket. Headed out west,